guys. So we are going to jump into Word again today, and this time talk about editing documents. Now that is an all-encompassing word, editing. And believe you me, with all the capabilities this program has, it could be several videos, but we're going to focus on some main editing features in this video. So I'm going to open up a document I have ready to go. And then I'm going to zoom out a little bit so you can see a little bit more of the document. It has a nice header here, and then it looks like a letter for immediate release, and then it describes a series. Now, the first thing we need to think about is if we want the changes we're making to be permanent on this document. And yes, I'm talking about saving. If we don't, if this is a template of some sort, then the first thing we're going to want to do is go File, Save As, to save a second copy of this document. And so I could type in B1 Doc1 or whatever you would want to name it so that it doesn't override my original document. We will notice that the name changes as well here on the top. So now I can edit this and know that the original template is still solid. Now I'm going to scroll down here until the title is just towards the top of my screen. And I am going to turn on our formatting marks again. Now I want to select a sentence here in our third paragraph. So I'm going to click here right after the O so I can grab the comma in the space and then go down ever so slightly to where it highlights the entire line. Once I've done that, it's going to pop up the mini toolbar. But what I want to do is not on that, so I'm going to ignore it because I want to cut this text. Now to cut, there's a couple of ways we can do that. You can right click and select cut. A lot of people do that. There it is right here at the very top. Or you can Control X. Control X is for cut. Control C is for copy. Those of you using a Mac, it's Command C or Command X. So I'm going to select cut here and it will take that out of the paragraph. I'm going to paste the text here right in front of the word Africans. Now to paste, we can Control V or Command V if you're on a Mac, or we can click the paste button over here. If we hit the down arrow, we'll see all of our different paste options. The first one is keeping the formatting of the source. So if I copied this from another document, it would keep that document's formatting, so different fonts, size, etc. Might not be a good idea if you're wanting consistency. Or we can merge the formatting, paste it as a picture, or keep text only. A lot of times if I'm pasting text from another document, I go with the keep text only feature because then I know it is not pasting any formatting with it because formatting is more than just a font and a color. There could be some behind the scenes stuff going on that when you paste, you're like, why is my document acting this way? So pasting as text only ensures that you are only adding text and all the formatting it will absorb from the document it's going into. So I'm going to go ahead and select that option and it will add in that sentence back where I want it. I'm going to hit the space bar so that there's a space between the period and African. And obviously here it's noticing there's an extra comma. So I'm just going to backspace that out. Still give me a grammar error. So I'm going to right click to find out and it says there's extra space. So I'm going to select the top here, which is removing the extra space. And now we're good. Now I'm going to jump down to my fourth paragraph here, and I decided I want to move this sentence that says ticket prices include lunch down to this paragraph, which talks about the tickets. That's probably a better placement for it. To move this sentence, all I have to do is highlight it like so, and then once I hover over it, we notice the pointer change to the white arrow. I just hold down my mouse. And then notice that now we have a little box. It's because it has that selected text. So if I go down to this paragraph, the end of it, and then let go, it automatically moved the whole sentence. How cool is that, right? So now it's in a better placement. Now let's talk a little bit about copy. I'm going to go up here to the top headline of this document and grab the word travel luncheon. I'm going to copy it, which again, you can right click or you can Control C, Command C, select copy. I'm going to paste that text here in our third paragraph where it says our speaker list for 2016. I want to make sure it's pointed out that it's the travel luncheon. So I'm going to click here after the space and then I want to paste the text. But if I just do a simple paste watch, oh, it's horrible. It's big. It doesn't match the rest of the paragraph. That's what I was talking about with being careful how you paste. So I want to undo that. To undo that, I can click this back arrow here. And this time I want to paste, but text only. And see, whenever I did it that way, it kept it with the same font size as the rest of the paragraph. So now that we've cut and pasted some text, let's talk about the Office Clipboard. The Office Clipboard allows us to collect text and graphics from files created in any Office program, not just Word. The clipboard holds up to 24 items, and unlike the System Clipboard, The items on the office clipboard can be viewed. To display the office clipboard, we simply click the launcher in the clipboard group on the Home tab. Now, the launcher is this little corner here. And you click on it, and it will open up the clipboard panel on the left. And then it will show us items that we have cut or copied, and it will reflect them on our clipboard. So at any time, we can go ahead and click. Let's say I wanted to add the text again somewhere. I'm going to just go after this paragraph, and then I can click on the item, and it will add it in. Of course, I don't want to add that word there, but just wanted to show you how easy it was. So if you've copied a lot of text and something you copied that you forgot to paste, you can go into your clipboard, find that item, and paste it. It has built-in virtual memory. But just remember again, 24 items only. And when you're done viewing those items, you can always click to clear all, and it will empty out your clipboard. So let's fill up our clipboard. I'm going to highlight this paragraph and right-click and copy it. I'm going to highlight this one and copy it, and so on. See how now it's starting to fill up, and it gives us a preview of that text. Of course, they're longer paragraphs, so we don't see the whole darn thing. So now I'm going to just grab a word here, copy that word, and see how the word's here. It will show the most recent at the top. If we want to remove a specific item, we can just hit this list arrow here and select delete. Now, if it gets full, it's not going to just not let you copy anymore. You can continue to copy to your heart's content, but it is going to start to delete that 25th record and so on. So it's going to push the older ones out as you add new ones in once it gets to 24. Now let's talk about how to find and replace text. The Find and Replace feature in Word allows us to automatically search for and replace all instances of a word or phrase in a document. Now, these features are housed in the Editing group, which is over here on the right. And I just click on the Replace button to launch the Find and Replace dialog box. Now, although we're in the Replace section, Find is right here. So if we want to find a word or replace the word or go to a specific location in the document. So I'm going to stick here with the Replace tab, and I'm going to look for the word luncheon. Then I'm going to press Tab to get into the next field, which is Replace With. So I'm going to say find every occurrence of the word luncheon and replace with lecture. Now, before I launch this, we're going to click on this More button here to open up some more options. In this instance, I do want to match the case, so I'm going to select that. And it tells me that I added it up here. Option search down match case. Once I've done that, I'm going to hit replace all, and that will automatically replace all the words at once. And it tells you how many it did. It said we made 0 replacements. You want to search the rest of the document. Waha! Word was very smart. I had one word selected when we were playing around with copy and paste. So since just one word was selected, and it wasn't the word luncheon, it didn't make any changes. But it knows that I might have done that in error, which I did. So it's asking me if I want it to look at the whole document. So I'm going to click yes. And it's still saying that we made 0 placements. You want to search from the beginning. Again, the options, you could still see them over here in the back, were search down and match case. So it searched down from the word I had selected. That was only half of the page. So now it's asking me if I want it to start from the beginning. And yes, I do. So let's select yes. And there we go. It says all done. We made 3 replacements. I'm going to click OK. I'm going to close this out. And see, here's what I'm talking about. I had this word selected. So it checked this one first, checked this point down second. Then it reviewed the top half when I said to start from the beginning. And see here, right next to the word travel, now it says lecture series. And down here where it says travel lecture. And then the third one is right here, travel lectures. It replaced 3 words. Perfect. Now let's play with Find. I'm going to click on the Find button here, and it opens up the navigation pane on the left. And I'm going to type in luncheon, but this time without a capital L, hit enter, and we will see that it pops up once. It selects and highlights the text for us to easily see it. So I'm going to close this out, and then I'm going to change this luncheon to lecture, but in lowercase. Now it's, of course, important always to check spelling. I can see some red squigglies already. We can use the spelling and grammar command to search the document for misspelled words and grammar errors. We can find that in our review tab here at the top, in the very front, spelling and grammar. So I'm going to go ahead and click on it now, and it's starting to show our issues here. So the first one is a repeat word. So I can click to delete repeat word, and it fixed it. Inaugural was spelled wrong. So I'm going to click on that to change that. And then it tells me spelling and grammar check is complete. Now you may find an occasion where it will show you a word that's spelled wrong, that's not spelled wrong. Let's see if it does it with my name. It usually does. Nope, I've already added my name to a dictionary before. So let's purposely spell a word wrong. Character. Let's say that this was someone's last name. If we right-click on it, of course it's thinking it's spelled wrong, but we can click to add to the dictionary. And then now if I ever try to spell this word, it's going to acknowledge that it is an okay word to spell, and it will no longer prompt me to fix it. Now let's talk about using research information. The word research feature allows us to quickly search reference sources and the World Wide Web for information related to a word or phrase. Now, I actually use this feature quite a bit because I like to use colorful words. I don't want to use the same words all the time. So let's put this thesaurus to work. I'm going to scroll down here to this fourth paragraph which says noted. I'm going to highlight this word here and I want to put a different word. That's just not cutting it for me. Once I've highlighted that word, I can just click on the thesaurus in the proofing group and it will give me additional words on the right that I could use instead of. So renowned, well-known, famous, distinguished, a lot of very nice and elegant words. And so I'm going to go ahead and go with this word prominent here. And if you click on any of them, it will give you additional words based off of that word. And I like this word prominent, so I'm going to click on the down arrow here and select insert, and it will replace that word, the newly selected word. Now let's talk about adding some hyperlinks. Now there is a couple of different ways we can add some hyperlinks. We can add links to web pages or links to other documents. Caution, if you are linking to another document, it needs to be the same path for the end user. If I link to a document, for example, on my computer and then email them only this document, they'll click to try to access the other document and not be able to find it because they're not on my computer. So if you're linking to other documents, make sure that you have a folder. Send them that whole folder. Most likely you're going to have to zip it so that the links are intact and not broken. More often than not, to avoid that very common mistake, I will link to direct links or, for example, website links when possible. Down here at the bottom, I believe we had a link. Yep, we did, the Quest Specialty Travel. So I'm going to highlight this entire website link here. I'm going to copy it, and then I'm going to go to Insert and select Link from the Links group. When it opens it up, at first, of course, it assumes I'm going to link to another document in the same folder, but I can delete out this address and paste Control V, the link here in the address bar, and click OK. Now, when they're reading the document, not only do they see the web address, they can hover over it and it will tell them to hit Control Click to go to the link. Very neat, right? Now, one more thing in this video, let's talk about document properties, because it's important for us to understand our document's properties before sending this out to others. We want to make sure that our document doesn't have private or confidential information embedded in it. Our info screen in the backstage view includes tools for stripping a document of this sensitive information. So to do that, we just go to the File tab, which takes us into the info screen. Notice it says the word info here. I'm going to scroll down here to the bottom and click where it says Show All Properties, and we'll see a lot of information here on the right. It will tell us the size, how many pages, how many words, how long we have edited this document, the title of it, if a template was used, when it was last modified, and related people. If I scroll up here to the top, I can click the properties word and click advanced properties to see even more information. So what we want to do before we send this out is inspect our document or check for issues. So I click on this and then I'm going to select to inspect document. It's going to tell you to make sure it's saved. And then it asks us what we want to check. I'll just leave them all checked and click inspect, and then it will return the results. Everything else is good to go except for here, document properties and personal information. The following document information was found, document properties and author, and it asks if we want to remove it. I can click remove all and it will wipe that out. So if I re-inspect, inspect again, now the document is good to go. I'm going to go ahead and click close, and now my document is ready to send. Now, just in case I wanted to secure this document even further, I can go back into the info page and select to protect document. If I do this, for example, mark as final, it will make it to where it's read-only and the people receiving it can't make any changes to it. I can add a password, but heed my warning, there is no place that this password is stored. So if you forget it, you are never going to get in the document again. So be very careful with password use. We can restrict the type of editing people make. We can restrict access, which is a great way to allow people to read only and not edit or copy or print without marking it final in case you want to make more changes later. Or we can add a digital signature. There are a lot more additional options if your document is something you don't want messed with. So now it's good to go. I'm going to go into my home tab here, turn off my formatting marks, click here to save it. And that's it for this video. In our next video, we're going to talk about formatting text and paragraphs, bullets and numbering, borders and shading, and even insert some online pictures. So be sure to check that out. As always, thanks for watching, and I will catch you later.